It is finally here, the ability to use dynamic filtering inside of our linked records natively within Airtable. This new announcement caught us all by surprise last week, and I'm excited to dive into it to show you how to use this amazing new feature. So if learning about this is of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth, and this is Gap Consulting, where we help you to get organized and automated within no-code tools. And Airtable is one of our favorite no-code tools, and I'm very excited that they finally came out with this amazing feature. Dynamic filtering for linked records has been a big ask for a long time. And if you're not sure exactly what that is, I'm going to be walking through it step by step, and most importantly, how you can implement it with a few different examples in your database builds. But before we get into that, I first want to invite you to join me for free training. If you're new to Airtable, you really need to understand all the fundamental components of this software. So I have put together an Airtable crash course to teach you exactly this. You can grab that free crash course at gapconsulting.io/airtable-crash-course, and I will include links wherever you found this video. But without further ado, let's go ahead and hop on into my screen so I can show off the amazing new capabilities. So in order to get this set up to start, we need three tables. So first and foremost, I've picked the very common example of doing this between countries and cities because I think it really makes a lot of sense. So our first table is countries, and we've listed out four countries as you see here. I've got England, France, Germany, and Italy. And they are linked to cities. We're going to get to this next link in a minute, but right now I just want to focus on the combination between the country and the city, how we've connected those two things. So here on this link, this is a typical standard link. Nothing fancy going in here. The only thing I want to highlight, of course, is that this is allowed to link to multiple records, because one country very often is going to have more than one city. Okay, so we've got multiple records on this side of things. The next table down is cities. And similarly, we've got four cities linked to each country. And again here, nothing weird, right? There's no fancy filtering, nothing happening. This is the back end of our structure. We're saying we know this city is connected to this country. We're going to use that logic in the next step. So here, we do not allow linking to multiple records because a city only is ever inside one country and nothing else here is toggled on. So now that we have the key two components, that's the back end structure, now we're getting to the third layer where we're going to apply the dynamic filters. So imagine now that we have some sort of submission. Here on our submission table, we're going to first link to a country, and then we want to filter down the cities based on whatever this country is. This is, in effect, dynamic filtering for linked records. We want to say, hey, I'm always going to pick the country first, and when I go to pick the city, I only want to see cities that are in England. Well, before, we did not have the capability of doing a dynamic filter, meaning when we established a filter, it was static. It did not change over records throughout our system. So if I were to set up a rule that said, hey, I want these cities to only be cities that are in England, well then if I picked a different country down here, let's say France, then I would see again the cities linked in England. It was a static filter. But now the filter has expanded to become dynamic, and here's how we built that. So inside of our linked relationship here, again, this is to our second table, because first we will determine that country is selected, then we will pick the city. We're coming down here to the third toggle option that says filter record selection by a condition, and you'll see that this is new. Now, quick pause. You might also notice that I have a fourth one down here that says use AI to show top matches. This is also new and is not important for what we are discussing here. Now, I am on a beta trial for AI, although I'm pretty sure it's rolling out within just the next couple of weeks. So this may or may not be showing up on your screen as well. It's not needed for what we're doing here. You can just ignore it. I'm looking for filter record selection by a condition. Now, I should also highlight at this point that I tried this on a free plan and it did not accept it. I got an alert that said you must be on the upgraded team's plan. So if you're not spending whatever it is, $20-ish dollars per month per user to be on that upgraded plan, you're not going to have this capability. So in order to establish this, let's start from scratch. I'm going to ditch this entirely. And the first thing I want to do is either add a condition or a condition group. A condition group is helpful if I have a lot of conditions that I want to include all together as part of one holistic group. I don't need that for our simple example, so I will just add the singular condition. And here I'm going to say, well, I'm looking at the countries field. Now, bear in mind, I'm talking about this third table, my submissions table. And so here in my submissions table, I only have three different fields. I have name, country, and city. So I select country because I want to make sure that whatever country is selected in this particular linked relationship, that's what I'm analyzing. But here's where it gets dynamic. Before, if we wanted to make a selection, we would have to hard code a particular country. The country is always England. Not very helpful for the condition where we pick anything other than England. We want this to be dynamic. And so in order to get that, we hit the gear icon that was not here previously. And we now have dynamic conditions. So I make the selection here, again from the dropdown, and this is the dynamic component. It is going to analyze whatever's in my country field for that specific record and then bring it into this particular record. So my country is my country, whatever's been selected for that country. And in the condition where that country matches, then I am set. I am going to see the right cities for that country. So let's take a look. We're going to save up, confirm the change. And here, now that I've made that update, I can look at my cities. And here I have London, Birmingham, Nottingham, and York, all cities within England. I'll make a selection here. And now in my second record, I'm dealing with France. So when I select the city here, I see four cities from France. So my dynamic linking is all correctly established. One thing that I feel like I may have misspoke on earlier is in regards to the city here. When we're looking at this, we're looking for countries, and I want to highlight the way this is spelled. This is the plural, right? Countries. Has any of the country selected? So what we're looking for is in the city, when we are looking to filter down the city back here, this is countries, plural. So we are looking for this part right here to match what is selected right here. That is exactly what the dynamic linking is saying when we set it up this way. So it's sometimes easier for you to understand and visualize this if you're sure to use this specific language, as I've done here, where my field in this particular table is called country singular and the other one is countries plural. And that helps me keep straight where I'm looking at that moment in time. Now, a couple of closing thoughts on this. At the time of this recording, which is March 2024, this feature is not yet available inside of forms. So you'll notice here that I built out an interface, and when I go into my interface, my form within the interface, I want to establish the same kind of concept here. And in my city selection on the form, if I go over to my filters, you'll see that I can say countries has any of, and then I can pick a country. But I don't have the dynamic component that was just released inside of Airtable. So unfortunately, at the time of this recording, this is only available if you're working inside of the database itself, not inside of the interface. Now, I want to highlight that I also tried this inside of a form inside of Airtable. So not just the Airtable interface form, but also a data form within Airtable itself. Same idea here. When we look at the city option, we do not have, in fact, we have even less options for filtering down for the public form, right? So this is showing a field when conditions are met, country has any of, and again, we don't have that dynamic component. So this is not available for forms just yet, but hopefully, maybe that's coming. My final closing thought here would be to review the documentation that Airtable has put out. They go into a little bit more detail about the different things that are available here, cross-field type comparison within individual filters, single select and multi-select fields, and how they are or are not available inside of the dynamic filters right now. So check this out. I'll include links for this particular article wherever you found the video as well. Any questions you have that I did not cover here, please be sure to drop them below. And in the meantime, my friend, keep on building.